Alright, y'all, because I got the new Xbox and the new Madden, we gotta finish off Keegan Whitfield as we just finished off Christopher Thompson series yesterday. I'm not gonna lie, the ending of that was a little bit of a surprise. But I don't think this ending should be a surprise at all. We're 10-2. We're gonna win the Super Bowl. So the plan is I'm gonna play this game. I'm gonna do the rest of it on live on Twitch. Then I'm gonna do the last regular season game. Once we're in the playoffs, I'm gonna do all of that live unless it's the Super Bowl. So let's do it. That is my plan, at least. So that's great, you know. And I just realized I am recording on the Xbox. Oops, ass. Beautiful. Alright, well, 49ers uniforms aren't that bad. They're better than I would like them to be, but it's whatever. That's how I get my jerseys every game. Nice little random picker. It works usually too. Let's do this, y'all.
So now this offense will take over and they will have the football at their own 20-yard line.
Now a play fake here on first down. Oh, it worked. I wanted to go to Pickens.
By the former Toledo Rocket, Deontay Johnson. And they're going to get this beyond the 40 before he's taken down. One play has him up past the 40 already and another first and 10. Out of the gun, yeah. They'll look to throw. A quick throw there, going to be batted away and incomplete. The Steelers had 11-2 now. They've certainly found their groove of late, winners of 5 in a row.
And this team is absolutely playing their best football right now. This is the best that we've seen them play in a long time, partner.
So
sky's the limit as far as they're concerned. Their confidence really soaring.
Man, it was a prep All-American.
How did he get
through? It's Najee Harris. And the result here, a pickup of 8. Leaves him with 2 to go on second down. A look at the numbers for Harris in last week's game. 13 carries, a trip to the end zone to go along with 118 yards.
The way they ran the ball last week has to bring a smile to the faces of the entire coaching staff, because not only are they seeing a back pile up yardage, but they're seeing an offensive line in sync. And that bodes well this late in the season.
That one good for 14 yards and a Steeler first. On first and 10, Whitfield escaping the pressure right.
Oh, I was going to say if he caught that.
And that's going to be incomplete. Too tough to hold on to that one. It's second down. So after the incompletion on first, now second and 10. To throw again.
Oh, Whitfield. Jesus, he's got a block there, bud.
To it, and the screen never got started.
Against a team coming off a win, just as your team did the previous week, you talk about being physical all game long. Sometimes being physical is just being on the spot and helping force the incompletion.
Oh my God. You guys gotta hold on to the ball. I'm blaming it on the receivers.
Brandon, watching their tape from last week, I saw plenty of plays like we just saw there, forcing incompletions. It was key in their win last week. They're hoping the same thing happens this time out, too.
Now, meanwhile, they go for it on fourth down, and my goodness, incomplete.
Jesus, okay.
Nothing on the scoreboard, 0-0, as the offense gets ready to take over the football. They turn to Harris to begin the drive. And he's tackled a yard short of the marker. Good gain of 9 on first down. The previous run, good for 9. Here's second and a yard. Off play action. Whitfield is going to fire one deep over the middle. And that is incomplete.
Oh, my.
Nearly intercepted. The free safety couldn't quite get his hands around it, and it brings up third down.
Oh, okay. Come on.
Flush to his right. And that is incomplete. Oh, he had a defender right.
You got to hold on to that.
Force that to the ground. And
it's right in his hands.
That's what you're going to need to do against those big receivers. You got to get in there and get physical with them. That time he got in close, got in tight, and knocked the ball away.
The 30. 10. And into the end zone. Touchdown, Pittsburgh. The Steeler offense here about ready for their next drive. Things progressing to plan so far. Their defense has been solid, and they've got themselves a 7-0 lead after the touchdown the last time they had the ball.
And this is no time to even think about, hey, are we going to milk the clock? Hey, are we just going to do ball control? This is the NFL. 7-0 leads, they don't last very long unless you continue to push the envelope on offense.
On first down, Whitfield. They'll get this complete to Calvin Austin. And the tackle going to be made at the 38.
Never make the mistake that the slot receivers, especially the little guys like we're watching here, are just quicker than fast. A lot of them combine quickness and speed, and they catch a lot of footballs, as we just saw there.
Now a man open down the middle of the field and all the way inside the 15.
Cooking right now, guys. Cooking
it.
Now.
Call that a very strong gain of 24. Zone now. They'll look to throw toward the end zone, but that's going
like
to
how
incomplete.
My first thought is surprise, because that's one of the best.
I might just not throw
around.
The pass.
I've seen
him
pull in balls like this before.
Oh,
but
yeah.
How about a little credit to the defense forcing that incompletion?
Toward the back.
I had him.
The
I had him.
Zone, but he could not get the feet down.
I don't
this will wind up incomplete. This offense was on the move. Now two straight incompletions have him looking at 3rd and 10. They'll stick with the passing game as he looks to throw. And caught in
have
the end
yes.
zone. Touchdown. Steelers.
I kind of like Calvin Austin. I might.
Calvin Austin.
I don't know. It's like Deontay or Pickens. They need to get him. Wow. And don't have to spend tons of money on him.
Throwing on first down, Whitfield. And the coverage terrific there as that's knocked down and incomplete.
He looked back before Pickens.
An incomplete pass on first down. That leads to a 2nd and 10. Throwing again. Whitfield got his man complete over the middle. It's Johnson. 9 yards, and that leaves him just short, so it'll be 3rd and less than a yard. The 44, 50 yards rushing for him here as he starts to draw closer to a 1,000-yard campaign. On 1st and 10, Whitfield. And all this is taken in one-handed. What a catch. On 1st down, Whitfield.
Yeah, I might be throwing to Calvin Austin from now on.
And he'll be hauled down at about the 30-yard line. So 1st and 10 now from the 30. Looking to throw. Whitfield. Pickens on the slant. And he gets it all the way down inside the 10 and mark him at the 5. 25 yards that time. That's the number 2 receiver in the NFL in terms of yardage, and tell you what, a few more plays like that, he won't be number 2 for long.
Well, that's what often happens when you have competitors running around the field. These guys know where they...
And it's intercepted at
They're
the goal
line.
Picked off by Fred Warner. And I think he's going to go. They're not going to get him. The 20. And into the end zone, a pick 6 for the 49er defense.
Oh no, pick 6, Jesus, okay. I said I wanted a run, I did not get the run. I said I wanted it, I'd like to clarify that.
And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. Now the Steelers use the first of their 3 timeouts, as they'll stop it with just over 40 seconds to go in the first half. Throwing on 1st down. Whitfield. And nowhere to fit that football in. It's knocked away and incomplete.
He's smart enough to avoid the taunting rule, but I'll guarantee he quietly has told them, you might want to stop coming after me downfield because I just broke up another pass and took away a big shot that you were trying to succeed with.
And this will move the chains again as the tackle's going to be made at the 49ers' 22-yard line. Now another timeout called for by the offense as they'll stop it with a little over 30 seconds to go in the first half of play. Back to throw again. Got his man, it's caught for a Steelers touchdown. So the offense set to take the field here. They will have the football with less than a minute to go in the first half. They'll indeed try to run it out as they start on the ground. And he'll be brought down right at the 30 here. So we've reached halftime here with the visiting. All right, we'll bypass the halftime show in favor of returning to this late season game with the teams coming back from the locker rooms here a bit early. This fielded right at the goal line.
Yes, we will.
And he'll be stopped up at the 25. They'll start the drive with Harris, and he'll power ahead, but only for about 3 yards. Second down coming up. 3 yards on that last carry. Here's second and seven.
Never mind.
Back to throw. Whitfield is going to fire one deep, middle of the field. And that's caught inside the 30. And into the end zone. Touchdown, Pittsburgh.
Oh, no. Oh, yes. Perfect defense
here, about ready for their next drive. This drive here beginning probably with a pair of motivated
groups. Could have been really
bad. The offense scored a touchdown on their last time out, looking to repeat that. Charles's defense, they were very frustrated after giving up six the last time on the field.
And frankly, it's just a battle of wills in a lot of ways, because you know they're both motivated, they both game plan for this drive, and they both have specific outcomes in mind. To me, it just comes down to who can execute better, and which side can step up and assert its will over the other.
Now they face a 3rd and 10 after back-to-back incompletions. Operating from the gun, Whitfield, nowhere to go here, he lost the football. Dangerous spot for them to cough it up. Lucky to have recovered because had the defense gotten it, they were already within a shadow of the goalpost.
And then you're yelling at your own defense. Sudden change. That's not what you want to hear on your sideline. That means you've got to run out there and try.
Oh, a leap, and he will make the catch. And he is going to have the Steelers' first down as they manage to convert. And that'll keep the drive alive.
What a catch. Okay.
Off the play fake. Whitfield. Johnson with a completion over the middle. And he'll go down, but not before getting this inside the 30. On first and 10. Whitfield. And that is incomplete. He couldn't hold on through the contact. Brings up second down. Second and 10 here as we roll along in quarter number 3 from Santa Clara.
Yeah, no, he's done.
Caught left side.
He's done. Get him out.
The chains again as the tackle's going to be made at the 49ers 18. So from inside the 20, here's first and 10 at the 18. Harris running straight ahead. And he'll go down here at the 12-yard line. 69 yards rushing for him now to this point. The last run got 6, now 2nd and 4. They run again with Harris. And he'll be brought down this time at the 5-yard line. 7 yards on the pickup there, and now they'll have it 1st and goal.
Who all scored? Calvin Austin, Deontay Johnson, Cameron, Connor Hayward, and Gunnar Olszewski.
Now the offense back out onto the field as he'll take over here in the final minute of this 3rd quarter.
And now Najee Harris.
They'll start on the ground with Harris, and he'll power ahead but only for about 3 yards. Second down coming up. One quarter remains here on a Sunday night. We'll return with more after this. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. Again, it's Harris on second down. 3 yards on the pickup. That's going to set up an interesting third and about four to go. In search of 4 yards here to pick up the first down. From the gun on third down, Whitfield. There's Johnson with a reception. And he will have a Steelers first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
Yup.
Now a first down carry for Harris. And he'll take this ahead for about four. Second down coming up.
Brandon, I've got to think this offensive line has got some smiles on its faces. And I know it sounds crazy, but they practiced for this back in training camp. They knew they'd be in situations where it'd be extra defenders in the box coming after them, trying to keep them from locking down a game. Right now, they want to show the world they're up to the challenge.
Now a throw complete to his fullback out of the backfield. And they bring him to the ground just shy of midfield. The Steeler first down on the pickup of 11 yards. Off play action, Whitfield. And this will be incomplete. Physical play on the football there, and it's second down. After the incomplete pass, here now is second and 10. Off the play fake, Whitfield. He'll buy some time right. He's got this to Pickens. And this will move the chains again as the tackle's going to be made at the 49ers 26. That one good for 26 and a first down.
There we go.
They hand this off to Harris. Oh, and fine work there as he gets this thing down to the 11-yard line. Back-to-back nice gains. That one for 14 yards and another first. Off play action.
Let's see how many yards Harris has been.
They'll roll him out right. And that's going to be knocked away in the end zone. It's incomplete. The CD, they're up big, but they're still passing it. I mean, this is an offense that's had a lot of success in this game, and it seems like they're just having fun out there.
And it does feel like there's been a shift out there, doesn't
Ooh,
it?
Oh, I got lucky there.
Listen, if you're up, you can continue to do what you want to do. It's up to the other team to make you change how you do things. They'll continue to throw it around until stopped.
It's a good gain of 11. Sets him up first and goal. So another on-target throw, and that last one, Charles, going to put him up over 5,000 yards passing out for the season, and that is not an insignificant number.
Indeed it is not, because...
And he is going to go down back at the 11-yard line. Credit that sack to Dante Fowler Jr. So they get pushed back to the 11, and here's second and goal. Off the play fake, Whitfield sliding out of the pocket. And this is going to be intercepted. Picked up by Charvarius Ward. And the Niners are...
Oh, my God.
That one looks like he'll throw here. And that's going to be incomplete. Too tough to hold on to that one. It's second down. Well, their passing attack, even though that one was...
Oh, that's why it wasn't working, because Calvin Austin has nowhere else to go.
Touchdowns, and it looks like they're not going to stop throwing the football until the very end of this one.
Okie dokie.
Certainly make everyone involved on offense pretty happy, because that gives them all a chance to pad their stats a bit. But as far as the actual need, you and I both know they can just run this clock out, because this one, it was over a long time ago.
On third down, here's
I
Harris.
Hate you, whatever line you
want. That's not nearly going to be enough. Stopped at the 22, and he needed plenty more. A good pickup there, 7 yards, but it brings up fourth down.
We often talk of situational football. Let's just call it team football. The defense did their job, got off the field, brought up a punt.